the spotlight on engineering, procurement and construction major KEC International. Joining me now, Ramesh Chandak, Managing Director of KEC International. Ramesh, thank you so much for stopping by our Bloomberg studios. It's been a good year for you, 60% growth on the stock. What is the current order book status right now? Do you see greater order inflows in fiscal 14 as was in fiscal 13?
So our current order book is about 9,300 crore, roughly divided half into international and half in the domestic business. It really indicates that the domestic business has really improved a little bit because it used to be about 55-45.
Sure.
So domestic business, we picked up some good orders with Power Grid in some water section, in railway section. So really the business is growing on both the side. If you really look at the market today, market in UAE is quite good, Saudi is quite good.
Sure.
Central Asia, we are seeing Georgia, a lot of movement, Kazakhstan, Turkmenistan, Tajikistan. In Latin America, Brazil is doing very well.
Sure. Canada
is doing very well. Of course, there is not so much growth in Mexico. South Asia, we are seeing a lot of movement in Sri Lanka, in Nepal, in Bhutan, in Bangladesh. India, of course, is doing well. So overall, I expect that the order book will maintain slightly better than what we have today, in spite of very strong execution.
Sure.
During this first 6 months, our order book is still at 9,300 plus.
Of this 9,300 crores that you're talking about, how much of this do you actually see translating into revenues? And would you book that in fiscal 13 or do you think that's going to be booked over the next fiscal?
See, typically it is about 18 months average. So you can just divide by 18 months and monthly you can take more or less closer to that.
Okay.
So all our orders are broadly on an average about 18 months duration.
Ramesh, one thing the street has been watching out very closely for is your operating margins, specifically on the transmission business, which is basically the bulk of your revenues come from. What is the plan to improve your margin performance?
See, as it is, when we are seeing at the orders which we have received, the margins are better than what we had received last year. So the transmission will come next year because when we start executing these orders, even from the next quarter. So we'll definitely see improved margins in times to come. Of course, the margins are under pressure internationally also. It is not only the domestic. But we still expect that the margin on an average in and around 9% should continue for next year. This year, of course, margins were tight. Couple of reasons. One was we had just entered a year before in the water and railway. So we had taken some orders at a very low margin.
But these are new businesses.
That will get executed during this this year. So that impact will not be there next year. So definitely I am seeing that the next year margins will be better than this year.
Any numbers that you can give us?
At least 1% better than this year.
Okay. What about your debt level? I understand you have about 1800 crores of debt on your books. What is the plan to pay down your debt and reduce your finance costs?
See, first thing is that what kind of debt I have. See, I have largely working capital debt, which is again represented by the working capital assets. So they are all self-liquidating. So it is not the debt which is standing there. It's not actually the debt is moving every time it's getting paid and the new debt is created. And if you look at the debt on the fixed nature, which is very small. We have acquisition debt of SAE. And
how much would that be?
It's about 500 crores.
Okay.
And there is a debt relating to the our capex on the cable plant.
Sure.
That may be about 125 crores. That's the only debt we have, really long-term debt. Most of the debt is working capital, which is self-liquidating.
So are you comfortable with your working capital requirements and your operating cash flows?
Absolutely. I have not seen any problem in working capital requirement. Actually, if you see, the biggest thing in last 6 months of what happened, that we have actually reduced our debt by about 15-20 days.
Sure.
Our net working capital has reduced, our debt level has reduced. So actually, we have really freed cash. See, this 6 months, we have demonstrated 30% growth in sales without any additional borrowing.
Are there any plans to raise capital afresh through equity?
See, we'll raise the capital as and when required, but I don't think we really require capital. I don't want to raise the capital just for raising the capital.
Sure. The other issue, Ramesh, is about the currency. The currency has been extremely volatile. What kind of impact has it had on your own decision-making capabilities?
See, our policy is to really hedge 100%. So we really don't keep our currencies open. We have certain issues in relation to the loss in the quarterlies, which is mainly coming on the advance received, which is only self, again, because we'll get adjusted in the subsequent quarter. Even if we get a gain, the subsequent quarter, it will have adjusted to the loss. If we get a loss, it will get adjusted. But these are the advances which are already received.
That's largely mark to market is what you're saying.
Mark to market. That's the only, otherwise we don't have any loss on the currency account.
Okay. What is the assessment of the macro environment, Ramesh, at this point in time? You're seeing the 13th plan talking about enhanced investment in the T&D space, which is again an important space for you. The second important point is, of course, the fact that state electricity boards are being cleaned up. Are you seeing things improving in the sector as a whole?
See, things have to improve. The question is today that it might take about a year really to have the real impact of the improvement on the SEBs. Right now, all SEBs have increased the prices. So they will have a cash in times to come. Similarly, government has come with a plan, debt restructuring plan, so that will also help them. And ultimately, the SEBs will have to improve, and they will improve, and that business will come in about 6 to 8 months' time. So for the power grid, which is the biggest customer, all investments are on track. They are investing in time. There are no issues with the power grid. They have been the best performing utility probably over all the years.
Sure.
So I'm sure that they will complete their whole capex plan this year also. So I'm not seeing problem. The issues are that I am seeing a lot of opportunity in railways coming because now the DFC is almost coming and the bidding will start for DFC. Similarly, fortunately now some investment in railway itself will start moving, which was really not focused for quite some time.
Sure.
So that is getting focused, and I think the new minister is really talking about putting a lot of investment in railways. I am seeing water also doing very well and a lot of utilities. There is a lot of awareness about the environment, and I think government, the treatment of water is very important. So I'm seeing a lot of growth, which are the new divisions which have started, water, railway, telecom, power system.
Sure.
I'm seeing a lot of growth there.
Sure.
So overall, I'm seeing that the turnover should grow almost for next 3-4 years, looks very visible that it should grow. And even the margins will stabilize and will be slightly improved.
Ramesh, many thanks for joining us.
Thank you very much. Thanks, Rich.
On our studios, Ramesh Chandak from KEC International. Up next in business, Sajid Chinoyo, JP Morgan will join us on the Indian economy, FISC, and is there a case for a ratings downgrade. Back in business, 2 minutes.